2011 was a bittersweet year for Apple. It debuted two headlining products among others, but it also lost its leader and founder. Steve Jobs' death hit his fans and the tech industry hard. Before his death in October, Jobs stepped down as CEO in August, handing over the reins to COO Tim Cook. At 56 years old, Jobs left behind a legacy that impacted the lives of millions with devices that are used on a daily basis. Fans wrote tributes to him on the sidewalk outside of his Palo Alto home, and Apple stores became makeshift memorials to the entrepreneur. Just a few days before his death, with his absence noted, the company introduced the iPhone 4S, a phone which externally is almost the same as its predecessor, but internally has beefed up hardware and improved software. Siri, the phone's voice recognition software, became a personal assistant for users, able to schedule appointments, find local businesses, and answer questions.
Set an alarm for tomorrow morning at 5 a.m.
Your alarm's set for 5 a.m.
Fanfare at Apple stores has been more and more subdued each year, but still, fans lined up around the world to become one of the first to get their hands on the gadget. In one of his last public appearances before his death, then-CEO Steve Jobs made a surprise appearance and introduced a thinner, lighter, and faster iPad.
We've been working on this product for a while, and I just didn't want to miss today, so...
The iPad 2 was an instant hit with more than 500,000 sold in its first weekend. Tablets disrupted desktop, notebook, and netbook sales, but they're also the driving force behind the growth in the PC market, according to analysts. Apple's tablet shipments grew by 166%, according to analysis firm Canalys, but its share of the worldwide market fell from 96% in the third quarter of 2010 to 67% in the third quarter of 2011 as a result of increasing competition from rivals. Apple's iPad has become the tablet to emulate. Many companies this year played catch-up to Apple, and some, like Microsoft, aren't even in the game yet. Microsoft plans to debut Windows 8 beta in early 2012, which will run on both PCs and tablets. Jobs made his final public appearance when he introduced the company's iCloud in June. iCloud stores documents, calendars, contacts, photos, and music online and syncs them to multiple devices.
Keeping these devices in sync is driving us crazy. So, we've got a great solution for this problem.
Apple joined Amazon, which by the time the iCloud became available in October, Amazon had already made available its cloud player. Shortly after Apple, Google joined the pair and offered a similar service. The company was caught up in controversy after it was revealed in April that iOS devices track their users even when location services are turned off. The iPhone and iPad were shown to have stored location data about users. Apple responded by saying that the phones were maintaining a database of Wi-Fi hotspots and cell towers to help iPhones more rapidly calculate its location when requested. Google's Android OS was also shown to log location data. 2011 was a particularly litigious year for Apple, butting heads with Amazon over its App Store and having a long tussle with Samsung over its tablet. A district court in Dusseldorf, Germany blocked sales of the original version of Samsung's 10-inch tablet in September, after Apple convinced the judge that Samsung's product looked too much like the iPad. In the midst of the court battle, we saw Samsung's tablet disappear from its booth at the IFA Consumer Electronics Show in Berlin. To circumvent the ruling, Samsung modified the appearance of the tablet to create the Galaxy Tab 10.1N. The modified tablet has a new bezel and speakers on the front of the device, but that didn't satisfy Apple. The company filed another injunction against Samsung in November, with a hearing scheduled for late December. The filing in Germany came as Apple registered a loss in its legal battle with Samsung in Australia. The federal court there decided to overturn the injunction that banned the sale of the Tab in the country. And that's a look back at Apple News from 2011. In Boston, Nick Barber, IDG News Service.